हेलो स्टूडेंट, दिस इज पूनम दंडारे, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर ऑफ डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी ऑफ तुलसीराम जी गायकवाड़ पाटिल कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी नागपुर। इन दिस सेशन वी हैव टू सी द जावा क्लासेस एंड ऑब्जेक्ट। सो क्लासेस एंड ऑब्जेक्ट, इट इज़ अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक इन जावा। एवरी मेथड, एवरी एट्रीब्यूट, एवरी फंक्शन वी हैव टू रिटर्न इन अ क्लास, and class contain the object. So it's a very important topic in Java. So we learn about the classes and objects in Java. So basically, an object in Java is the physical as well as a logical entity, whereas a class in Java is a logical entity only. Object is the physical as well as the logical entity, and class is the only logical entity in Java. So we have to study about the what is an object in Java. So an entity that has and behavior is known as an object, that has a state and behavior is known as a object. So for example, like a chair, bike, marker, pen, table, car, etc. For example, in this you have to just see that is a fruit. Fruit is a class, and that class has an object like apple, banana, mango. So these are the some physical and the logical entity. So particularly the object has been characterized in the three parts. So that the state, the object, each object should have a state, behavior and identity. So what do you mean by state? State represent the data and the value of an object. Behavior represents the behavior, functionality of an object, such as deposit, withdraw, that is, these are the some behavior of a bank. Then identity is an object. Identity is typically implemented via a unique ID. For example, the data of the students, there is a registration number should be a unique. Name should not be a unique, but registration number should be a unique, or mobile number should be a unique. So the identity should be a unique ID. The value of the ID is not visible to the external user. However, it is used internally by the JVM to identify each object uniquely. So there are the three characteristics of an object. So for example, in this, apple is an object. Its name is particularly depend on the fruit. That means apple is a fruit. So apple is an object and its name is fruit. So color should be a reddish, so known as its state. It is used to eat, and so writing, so particularly the identity or behavior should be the, that means it should be for, it is used for the health. So these are the some characteristics of that apple. So we have to just define a object. So an object is an instance of a class. Object is an instance of a class. A class is a template or blueprint for which objects are created. From a class we can create an object. That means if class is a car, that means car is a class. So the objects of a car is, that means there are the different types of cars, Volvo, Audi, Toyota. So these are the some objects. So these are the some particularly identity. So next one is the what is a class in Java. A class is a group of objects which have common properties. It is a template or blueprint from which objects are created. It is a logical entity, and it cannot be physical. A class in Java can contain field, method, constructor, blocks, nested class and interfaces, and and so many, that is the attributes. So these are the some particularly class. So class is a blueprint or a template of an or a blueprint of an objects which are objects are created. So Java is an object oriented programming language. Everything in Java is associated with classes and objects along with its attributes and method. So for example, in real life, a car is an object. The car has attributes such as its weight, its color, and method such as we have to use like behavior, we have to drive, and we have to brake. So a class is like as an object constructor or a blueprint for creating objects. So how to create a class? So to create a class, use a keyword class. So if you want to create a class, so you have to use a keyword class. Public is the access specifier. Public is the access specifier, private is the access specifier, and protected is the access specifier. There are the three types of access specifier in Java, or more than, that is the default. Like, so you have to create a class by using a keyword class, and with class we have to write a class name. So the class name should be a, that the name of the class, that the first letter should be a capital. After that we have to open with a curly bracket, then write a method, writes an attribute, and close with that particular curly brackets. So that this is the structure of a particular class to create a class. Next, create an object. How to create an object? So in Java, an object is created from a class. So we have already created the class named main. So now we can use this to create object, because every class has an object. If you want to access the property, access the attribute, or access the method, you should have to create a particular that object of that class. By using object, you have to access the class method. So to create an object of main class, specify the class name followed by the object name and use the keyword new. This is the way to create an object. That means here we have to create a class main, and in that class main you have to just write here an attribute, that is the int x equals to 5. It is the attribute of class main, and in that last we have to write a main method. So main method, after that we have to create, in main method we have to access the attribute of class by using to create an object. So how to create an object? So we have to create the, specify the class name followed by the object name, then equals to new as a keyword and class name as a function. So by using this we have to create the object of that class, and by using the object we have to access the attribute of that class. So system.out.println, my object is the object of class main. So by, I want to access x, so I just write here the my object dot x. So dot is the access specifier. Then we can create a multiple object of the same class. So we have to just write here object 1 and object 2. So we have to create n number of object of the same class. Not mandatory ki we have to create for one class there is only one object. No, we have to create the n number of objects. So next one is the using multiple classes. So we have to create a multiple object. So same, we have to create a multiple classes also. So for example, in this we have to first create a class main, and we have to just write here attribute x equals to 5 of that class main. Second, we have to create a class second, and in class second we have to just write here a particularly main function, and main function we have to create the object of class main. So we want to access the property of x, so we have to create, but when we have to save the file, we have to save the file, then you should have to write the class name in which the main method should be write. That class, that means if my class is, I just wrote the main class in the second, so the extension of that, I just save the file with the second.java. When we have to save the file, then your class name should be same as your file name. Your file name should contain the same as the class name. So just we have to save second.java. Sorry. So this is the particular multiple classes. So thank you so much.